What is up, lads and lassies? It's your boy, Lug of the Mun, back with another flow-free speedrun. Oh, yeah. So today we're coming at you with the 9x9 mania time, and this is actually my first time attempting a 9x9 mania speedrun. And I got the world record by 4 seconds, so that's honestly kind of neat. I did not expect to do that at all, but yeah, I mean, I'm not going to complain, don't get me wrong. But so the reason I did this in the first place was... So I was on YouTube, and in my recommended feed was Mr. Taco Eater's 1815 from a couple days ago, because he's been on a bit of a grind. He lowered his time for Classic Pack, for Kids Pack, and for 9x9, obviously. But as I was just watching that today, and I was like, I wonder what my time would be like if I was to attempt a run of this. So... emboldened by this fact, I attempted a run and beat the record. So that's just how it goes sometimes. I mean, I feel like as the boards in the game get bigger, I feel like the disparity in skill between me and most other players just kind of becomes more and more apparent. And by players, I mean just like any players, not necessarily other runners. And I'm not trying to say that to sound like, oh, I'm the best in the world. Like, obviously not. I mean, there's definitely people who are better than me. But I do think that I am pretty good at just seeing a level and instantly solving it in my head and just knowing how it works. That's something I noticed with Mr. Taco's gameplay, is that he plays different than I do. Like, he released a video not too long ago that was like proof that I don't treat it flow free, which was honestly kind of interesting to watch, because like the way he connects, like the way he uses his thumb to connect the dots is a lot different than mine. Like, he uses his thumb like very straight, whereas I just kind of use the tip of my thumb, which is, it's just, it's interesting to see how different people play the same game. And also the way he connects the pipes is different than I do. I almost always start in the top left. There's a pipe in the top left, I almost always start there, whereas he kind of just tends to start wherever. I didn't really see a pattern to his, like, starting. I mean, he sometimes started in the top right, like, sometimes, but other times he just wouldn't. It was kind of weird. Whereas if for me, if there's a flow in the top left, I almost always start there. Or just, like, it's usually on the left side. Like, for that map there, for level 17, there wasn't anything on the left. For that one there, for that brown one. See, watch me... watch the gameplay not coincide with what I'm talking about at all. But, yeah. I made a lot of mistakes in this run, though. Like, 9x9 is definitely a lot more optimizable than it is currently. In the Discord, we've discussed it potentially being able to go down to, like, a 15-minute time range. Because... which is pretty crazy stuff, if you ask me. But it's definitely in the realm of possibility, don't get me wrong. So anyway, as the avid viewers among you have probably noticed, I have not posted in over a month or so, which oops, sorry about that, but I kind of got busy with like life and stuff, cuz you know, I don't only play flow free for a living. So it's not that I haven't been playing the game. It's far from it, actually, and I have attempted some runs. I just haven't had time to like record and stuff, but I had time tonight, so I just kind of did a run and it worked out just fine. But I do want to do more runs. Like, I did attempt some runs of Classic Pack, just because Classic Pack is like the most popular pack by far, so it's also the one that's like most contentious among the community. So I kind of want to lower my time a bit more, that way I have a bit more of a cushion than the 3 seconds I currently have, you know. But I mean, it's whatever. I also tried live commentary again, because I feel like that would be better, especially if I'm trying to get world record runs, because that way you can actually hear my live reaction to getting the world records instead of just post commentary, because it's a lot better to capture things in the moment rather than after the fact. It's just kind of how things work. Also, if you hear background noise, it's my cats. They're being really annoying today, so sorry about that. So I think live commentary worked just fine, but there were times where like the screen recording function just would not work, and it was really weird. I don't know why, but I do want to do some live commentary videos. So if I don't vanish for a month again, you'll maybe see some of those if I can get it to work, which I know in my past videos, I'm like, oh, I'm going to do other content. I literally don't have time. I want to, but I do not have time to do those kinds of things. I'm already bad enough at time management as it is, let alone trying to balance a YouTube channel along with, like, school and stuff and work. And I want to, but I feel like that's just going to have disastrous consequences for my well-being. So, that's probably unlikely, but we'll see. So, for those of you who live in the United States of America, today is currently November 2nd, because that's probably when I'm going to post this, but a very important day is tomorrow, Election Day. And I'm not going to get into, like, the whole politics of it, because I am not qualified to talk about that at all in the slightest, and I'm not going to get into, like, my views either, because I'm not really sure where I stand, honestly, but I will say it's going to be a very important day going forward, because there's a lot of things at stake. Not even just, like, I don't know. It is definitely interesting, though. I'm interested to see where things go with it. I'm not really sure how, like, where, like, the standings are at the moment. I haven't really checked, but I don't know. Like, from what I've heard, it seems like the consensus is that people... I don't know. I should probably just stop talking about that. That's a very touchy subject for many people, but I have to fill, I don't know, like, a while of talking, and I don't really know what to... I'm not very good at coming up with things to talk about on the fly, so... So you can just kind of simmer and watch the gameplay unfold. I have no idea what the heck happened there, and that... So this is level 54. I totally just brain farted there and just did not play. So, yeah. So as I mentioned, I have been playing the game pretty frequently. I actually beat the game for the 8th time not too long ago. Like a couple weeks ago or something. So, that's pretty dope. I think the last time I posted a video, I think I'd beaten the game 6 times. So I've beaten the game 2 more times in that time span, which is... honestly kind of sad in a way, just by how much I play the game. I think there was one day I had like 4.5 hours in one day or something, which is a lot considering how much I have to do in a day. But so that's why my levels were all reset, is because I reset my progress and I haven't really played much, and I'm also doing it a different way. Like, I normally just kind of start with the top level and make my way down in chronological order. But this time I'm starting with the bigger packs and making my way back to the smaller ones. Because something that I and the other runners have discussed is a full game speedrun. Which sounds absolutely stupid, but I think it could work, potentially. Okay, honestly, I forgot I messed up on level 65 here. What happened is that the blue in the top right corner, I messed it up and didn't realize it. So I had to go back and fix that. So the fact that I still got a world record even despite that is kind of dumb. it really just goes to show how much work we still have to do with 9x9. Which is, 9x9 is like that threshold that's right before the levels start to get too big to optimize. Like, 9x9 is definitely still optimizable, but it's kind of pushing it, but just because it's a bit big. It's definitely still possible to optimize, but it's going to take a little work. I'm not sure if I mentioned this yet already, but we've discussed that... when I say we, I usually am referring to the Flow Free Discord, like the community we have, but which I will link in the description, and I will link in the description, by the way, but it just completely goes to show how much work we still have to do. We've talked about how we can probably get it down to, okay, maybe not like we, but like it's definitely maybe not definitely, but it's possible to probably get it down to like a 15 total time for the entire pack, which is kind of insane, honestly. Which I'm not sure if any of us are capable of doing that, but it is within the realm of possibility, just because I mean, there's people who aren't in the Discord who play the game, like, for sure. I mean, there's only, like, there's not that many people in the Discord yet, which I'm hoping to change, which is why I'm going to link in the description and stuff, just because this is a quality game that more people should play. But I do think it is definitely possible to get the time lower. But whether that's going to happen because of me or because of somebody else, I don't really know yet. But there are a lot, I just watching this run, it's just like, there's a lot of sloppy points. Like, I had to, like, restart levels, like, 3 times or something, which is just, I don't know. I definitely want to work on 9x9, because, as I mentioned earlier, I feel like the bigger boards are my strength, because I can solve them pretty quickly. I swear I had something else to mention, but I totally just brain farted. I went off on a tangent there about lowering times. I definitely had something else to say. I don't remember what it was. Maybe I'll think of it later. Something else I kind of want to do is that I kind of want to do something similar to what Mr. Taco did with his proof I don't cheat kind of video, where I have like a hand cam to show how I play the game, because like that kind of stuff interests me, like seeing other people do it. So I feel like it's kind of the same for other people wanting to see me play, just not only for like proof's sake, but just for like curiosity's sake, you know. Which is another reason why I kind of want to do live commentary in the first place, is just because, like, having it live is a lot harder to fake than post-commentary, you know? Like, I don't fake my runs, don't get me wrong. Like, I mean, ask any of my friends in real life, and they'll tell you that I'm obsessed with this game, and I'm pretty darn good at it. But, having it live and having those genuine reactions to things is definitely a lot better than after the fact, as I said earlier. But, I do think having a hand cam would definitely be beneficial at some point. I'm not sure how I'm going to set that up. I'll have to figure that out. There's a lot of things that I'm like, oh, I have to figure that out at some point, and I just kind of don't because I'm lazy. But I do want to do that at some point. It's just a matter of when. And when is a very subjective term that's prone to changing on a whim. So, yes. That is how things work in the land of logarithmon. Haha. So, yeah, there's still, like, 45 more minutes of commentary I've got to fill. Commentary is not my strong suit. Let's just say that much. I don't think I've got, like, a decent voice for commentating, but when it comes to actually speaking, not really at all. I mean, that's just kind of how it goes sometimes, you know? I do like that I tried to talk about the election, like, hoo-hoo, the election, hoo-hoo. But, I'm definitely not qualified to talk about that at all. Let's just say that I hope that whatever happens, it's the best for our country, and the people in power know more than I do. And that's probably for the best. As I said, I do kind of want to try more 9x9 in the future. I might also try something like 8x8, maybe 7x7. I think Taco's current time for 6x6 Mania is untouchable. Honestly, like, he has a 7:09, which is pretty ridiculous. Because, I mean, I attempted a couple of runs of 6x6, and they were, like, not very optimized, granted, but I got, like, low eights every time. So I have to somehow shave off a minute to even, like, try to compete with him, let alone beat his time, which is just ridiculous. He himself said that time was like a once-in-a-lifetime kind of thing. Which, I don't know. It just goes to show, like, how, I guess, like, impressive he is at the game. how honestly everyone in the Discord is at the game. Like, I mean, Ashkan said before that he's not all that good at the game, but I mean, he's on the leaderboards. He's second place for Classic Deck. I mean, that takes some skill. I mean, yes, it is also a bit of luck with how the boards go, but you don't get that high on the leaderboards without a bit of skill. So, honestly, this is the kind of game that really anybody can get good at with time, which is true for really any game, but this game I feel like is more so than most just because it's easily accessible. I mean, it's a mobile game, first of all, which is the entire point of mobile games, is that they're accessible to large audiences. It's a very simple concept, and it's easy to master. Maybe not, like, easy to master, but it's very easy to pick up. And it doesn't take long before you start to understand how the game works. I mean, granted, I played it for, like, every day in class for, like, a year or something.
Something like that.
And I took a... Excuse me, sorry about that yawn. But I took like, a couple month reprieve in there for a bit. Like, I just didn't really play much at all. But I came back with a vengeance, when was that? Probably, like, my junior year, sometime during there. Yeah, I think that's right, sometime during there. Because, as I mentioned before, like, I didn't even realize I was good until March of my junior year. So, and then over the summer is when I started actually, like, doing runs and, like, getting my name out there in the community, which is pretty small at the start of it, but it's actually gotten to be, like, a pretty alright community now, which is... Whew. Excuse me. Again, sorry about that. Which is pretty nice to see at the moment. So, yeah, I'm yawning because it's currently 11 p.m. Whoa, dude, you know the date and the time? Breaking the fourth wall. But, so, yeah, it's been a pretty long day for me, so I'm quite pooped. So after I'm done recording this, I'm probably just gonna head on over to bed soon, just because I need my sleep for school and stuff, because, you know, as much as I complain about school, I should probably, like, you know, be getting stuff done. On level 141 here, I attempted to do the yellow pipe first, and I was like, nah, but we don't do that. That happens a lot. Doesn't really happen very often for me, where I second-guess myself and switch to a different pipe at the beginning of a level, but it happens occasionally. But, yeah, just rewatching this run... Excuse me. Oh, man, I'm really sorry about that. Sorry about the yawns. But, as I've said many times already, but, just watching this run really just goes to show just, like, how much work there still is to do on this game. I mean, I feel like, Kids Pack doesn't have too much farther to go. Classic Pack, okay, pretty much, like, just all of the packs just have more room to improve. I mean, I'm honestly kind of hyped to see where the community can take the rest of the times, because I mean I was kind of the inception of the community. Like, I was a big part of it, so it just